going to get a second season out of this?
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Because, like, we've already done it all. Like, we can't really go anywhere. Yep.
Which, by the way, I love how they revealed it all in the first season.
Yeah, well.
I fucking love it.
But, yeah, there's a lot that happened, especially for, like, what you think is going to be, like, some lighthearted, dark comedy.
Yeah.
Right.
But, yeah, so after Judy takes all the money out of Steve's bank account.
Yeah.
And is then going to, like, put it
in a move.
a money order, right, for Jen. Then he comes over to Jen's house, which, looking for Judy to be belligerent mad at. And somehow, like, and again, you're like, he's, like, sort of riling up sympathy a little bit. And then, for some reason, whenever, and Jen has just found out that Judy did it and is pissed and mentions it, and Steve doesn't know that, she doesn't know that he wasn't in the car.
Right.
So just, like, blabs that to her. And then Jen instantly is like, wait a fucking minute.
Right. Which I thought, I was just like, that was dumb on Steve's part. It was just like,
what
you
an
think,
idiot.
Like, she's this pissed at Judy, like, but, like, you're okay? Like, come the fuck on.
Yeah,
like,
you know, she, like, would just be offering you wine. Like,
yeah. Like, clearly she does not know that you were involved here. but, yeah, anyways, continue.
Oh, yeah, but then, like, blabs to her. And then Judy had said when she was telling Jen that, like, she couldn't go back.
Mm-hmm.
So she instantly, you know, knowing Judy's personality, because they have become friends, she does know her in a way, even though she's kept this giant secret, is just like, oh, you. And focuses her anger.
Which is also, you know, so, which is why that whole, like, neighbor friend invite over, that scene becomes so crucially important right about now.
Sure. Even
because that's when Jen learns that if you tell somebody to leave and they don't, you could shoot them. And that's perfectly legal. And that's what she does.
Well, and we've seen, like,
amazing scene,
a little bit of abuse out of Steve, but we weren't, we cut away from that scene, right? So we don't know exactly what happened.
Right.
But I very much guess that, like, he went after her.
Right.
In some
He's
way.
Becoming, like, more verbally aggressive.
Right.
And definitely, like, the last thing I think we see is, like, he's approaching her, like, walking towards her while the gun's pointed in his face and is, you know, like, hey, like, I'm not leaving until you tell me where Judy is.
And then I love that that's who she calls.
Yeah.
Because she's figured out that's her only friend, so better for worse.
And they're going to continue on this Thelma and Louise trek
together. I'm super pumped about it. I think that, and then they did leave themselves in a good place for season two, because.
An amazing.
Yeah. Now it's like how to deal with this murder.
Right.
Like, because that's just.
Which is actually ties in a little bit to how Big Little Lies went. But, yeah, we should also talk about, like, one of the reasons I think this show shines so well is that the showrunner is a woman, Liz Spellman. She wrote for The Ellen DeGeneres Show and Two Broke Girls and a bunch of other things. I watched an interview with Applegate, and, like, 8 out of 10 episodes were directed by women. Most of the writers are women. Most of the producers are women. And so, like, we talked about, like, those subtle things, like, using the game chat to cheat and, like, you know, just the what happens after you have miscarriage, things like that. I think, like, all of these elements of the show would not be there if it wasn't clearly written by them.
I think
that's why there's so much connectivity, you know?
Yeah, 100%. I agree with that so much. I think that's so important to the show, too.
I do think that it's funny, like, whenever I'm just like, yeah, I'll believe that. Like, yeah, I believe that about, like, stuff, you know, like, yeah, maybe your emotions get riled and that's just, like, good writing. But, like, if it's very, like, plausible and believable, especially whenever it's concerning female characters, I'm just like, oh, what a surprise. It was written by a woman.
Yeah.
Versus, like, I mean, we've talked about in our Game of Thrones episodes, like, shit some women say, and you're like, a woman would never say that. You know, and I'm not going to get into, like, that there, but, like, there's so many other instances where I was just like, who wrote that? Like, clearly.
No kidding.
Yeah.
Somebody that does not know how a woman thinks or the things she would speak out loud.
Also, like, also a big surprise, I read a bunch of bad reviews about it written by men.
Oh, yeah, that's surprising. They probably thought it wasn't believable for women to act like that or something.
That wraps up our discussion, and now on to what are you obsessed with this week? So, what is yours, Olivia?
Okay. I might be a little late to the party, because I know it's been on Netflix for a while, but Unicorn Star, it's a movie that is on Netflix. You guys are looking at me like you haven't seen it, so nope. I'm really excited about it. Starring Brie Larson and Samuel Jackson.
I haven't seen this.
Oh my god, it's amazing. So Brie Larson is basically an artist just out of school, and kind of like settles into a boring like cubicle kind of copying printer sort of job that's really boring and really sucks, and she's really this like free-spirited, whimsical like artist that wants to like throw sparkles everywhere and rainbows and everything. But she like does this office job because she feels like she has to, and that's what everybody's expecting out of her. She gets like, you know, secret message to like, hey, you have an opportunity to buy a unicorn at the Unicorn Store, which is managed by Samuel L. Jackson. It's wildly fantastical, amazing, and it's basically just a warm-hearted like story like about being true to you and true to your heart. And it is so amazing, and I know that you both would absolutely love it, so you should absolutely watch it. It's a movie, I think it's like 90 minutes or something like that, but like, it is truly like Brie Larson at her like, you know, wholehearted homie, like, you know, quirky self best.
Wow.
And in my head, like, you know, after doing, like, they did like Godzilla or something together, or King Kong, one of those movies. And then they did, you know, like the Marvel movies. And then I feel like this, they were just like such good pals, Brie Larson and Samuel L.
That's
Jackson,
what I was
that
about
they
to
were
say
like,
is,
let's do a movie about unicorns.
I could use more of that dynamic, yeah, for sure, after Captain Marvel and like him really bringing out the best in her.
It was great. Amazing. And then, also Joan Cusack is in it and she's amazing. Yes. Also other faces you would love to see. So that is my obsession. Go watch it.
Cool. Yeah. Mine is this podcast called White Lies. So I wanted to talk about it because like kind of the like white lies, not always so white of lies in the show, but it looks at an old case from Civil Rights South that has been unsolved but has like a bigger political narrative. It kind of mixes like true crime and racial justice and history, and it's really incredibly done. And I think like importantly, it's sort of told by Southerners who like went off to do bigger media, so it has a really high production value, but they're from the area. And I think as someone from, you know, small town America, like that matters to me a lot when those stories are told by people who actually know the area. I highly recommend it. Just listen to the trailer and you'll be super hooked.
Nice.
All right. And for our guest, what about you, Lauren?
This is an ongoing love of my life, but it's going to be Lizzo.
Nice.
And the lyric that I always go back to is, why men great till they gotta be great?
Nice. That's probably a perfect way to cap off that discussion. Perfect. All right. Well, thanks again for listening. Please like and rate us on your favorite podcast listening app, and we will see you soon.
Thank you.